Welcome back to the channel, guys. In today's video, we're going over some lightsaber tricks you should know in Battlefront 2. These moves are a bit more advanced. If you're an intermediate player trying to up your game, this is the video for you. But even if you're a newer player, it doesn't hurt to see what's possible in the game. Before we begin, yes, I have to admit that these are mostly bugs or unintended mechanics for the most part. The game is 4 years old, and it was left in a half-finished state, so these bugs and mechanics are never going to get fixed. So my mentality is, instead of complaining about them, might as well get good at them, because at this point, they're just part of the game. I've got 7 advanced lightsaber tips for you, but before diving into them, I want to briefly go over the prerequisites: parries, double parries, and hook swings. I've covered each of these in the past, but they are the foundation for most of these moves, so it doesn't hurt to brush up. A parry, or riposte in true fencing circles, is a quick counterattack after blocking an enemy strike. If you attack the moment an enemy saber makes contact with your block, you'll parry the attack and cause damage. A double parry is the exact same thing, except you land 2 hits instead of 1, and it's all a matter of timing. Grievous's thrust surge is a really good ability to practice double parries on. And lastly, we have hook swings, which is just a basic jump attack combined with forward momentum and a 180 turn that lets you get behind your target's block and hit them in the back. If you're trying to do hook swings and you're finding that you're having a hard time getting that 180 off, maybe you have to up your sensitivity. I would recommend doing no less than 90% soldier sensitivity if you're going for hook swings. Personally, I have my sensitivity at 100 and it makes it just fine. So now that we've gone over the 3 prerequisites, let's go over the actual advanced tips, and we're gonna start with what I call the sneak parry. Keep in mind, I'm naming all of these and they're not official names at all. If you wanna call them something else, that's totally fine, but I'm calling this the sneak parry. Basically what this is when you dodge and you turn your camera 180, your character model will actually stay facing the direction they were dodging, but your camera will be looking behind them, and what this ends up doing is it lets you block attacks from the back, essentially. The trick is to not touch the camera movement once you've done the 180, because as soon as you adjust the camera, your character model will turn around to face the direction the camera is looking. But if you stay patient and wait for the opponent to try to hit you in the back, they will end up hitting your block and you can parry them in a sneaky fashion. Ergo, sneak parry. Moving on, this next tip is my favorite one in this entire video. I call it the dash hook combo, because only 3 specific characters can do it: Darth Maul, Yoda, and Luke, because they have that dash attack ability. Basically what this is when you do the dash attack, you turn your camera in a 180, and then you do a slight jump attack at the very end of the dash, and the momentum from the dash carries you forward while you do a jump attack. It's more or less a sneaky way to get a hook swing in there without actually having to do the hook swing, and what's cool about it is you do it out of an ability, so you're constantly applying pressure and doing damage. And as a bonus, even if you miss the hook swing, the momentum can carry you out of harm's way if your opponent tries to counterattack. Like I said, this is my favorite tip in this video, and I've been working on a nasty variation of this combo with Darth Maul. It involves the dash hook combo into a saber throw, getting both hits off the saber throw right into a chokehold, and the total damage is somewhere around 500. I'm gonna have to get that on footage so I can demonstrate, because it is disgusting. But again, this trick is only possible with Darth Maul, Luke Skywalker, and Yoda, since they're the only heroes with that dash attack. And you could even argue that Yoda's is the most dangerous, since the dash itself goes through blocks. Moving on, we're gonna keep up with the theme of hook swings, and this is what I call Count Dooku's sneak hook. Dooku, as far as I know, is the only one who can do this, and it has to do with his attack animations. If Dooku stands still and does 2 basic lightsaber swings, the third one can give him a boost of forward momentum, which can then turn into a hook swing, and it comes out of nowhere. I've tested this with other heroes, trying to see if their attack animations can lead to a hook swing, but I've found no other success outside of Count Dooku. This one will take a lot of practice because it has everything to do with the timing, and because your window to get that hook swing in is so short, you really gotta find the sweet spot. My biggest tip is, as soon as you see that second attack go, immediately go into the hook swing. A good way to practice it is to just get a forward jump going and not worry about the actual hook, and once you've nailed that forward jump, then try adding in the 180 and the attack. Also, just so you know, if you activate Duelist, this will not work, since Duelist changes Dooku's attack animations. Keep that in mind. Now, we're moving on to some of the more buggy tips in this video, and when you see it, you'll understand why. This first one has to do with Kylo Ren and his Frenzy ability. Normally, when you do this ability, you only get 3 hits, with the third hit breaking blocks, but with this trick, you can actually get 4 hits, with the third and fourth breaking blocks. The movement is pretty simple, but the timing might take some practice to get down. Basically, when you're in range, you want to dodge backwards away from your opponent, turn your camera in about 90 degrees left or right, and then activate Frenzy, and it will give you the fourth hit. I have no idea what causes this. This is a very strange bug. I think it has something to do with the fact that you're still locked onto your target even though you're not looking at them, and the game just freaks out. When you're first learning this, it can be difficult to keep your target in range. I recommend equipping Kylo Ren's Closing In Star Card. It'll give you 50% more range to work with. But Kylo's not the only one who can do this. General Grievous's Thrust Surge also locks onto targets, and if you do the same trick as you do with Kylo, you can make Thrust Surge actually go through blocks. In my testing, it's not the most consistent, at least not as consistent as Kylo Ren's fourth Frenzy. And the reason for that is it can still be blocked, but your opponent has to be facing the same direction that Grievous is going. If you psych them out and they turn the other direction, yeah, it'll go through their block. This one, in my opinion, is more fun than anything. I wouldn't really recommend trying it in a very competitive setting unless you're very confident in it and you know you can get it down. That's not me just yet. I still gotta practice this one a bit more, but just know that you can do it. So another move that all the lightsaber heroes can do is a bunny hop, although not all of them have a practical application for it. It's really simple. All you do is hold block and you time your jumps for the moment your feet touch the ground, and you will continuously jump with no breaks in between. It looks more silly than anything, and like I said, it doesn't really have a practical use for most of the heroes, except for General Grievous, because of his weird jump gravity. Since Grievous hits the ground way faster than every other hero, you can chain spam these bunny hops, and it looks pretty ridiculous, but with Grievous especially, when you start throwing attacks in there, some very interesting things start to happen. I'm sure you've seen this at some point, Grievous flapping his lightsabers like a crazy bird, but what's really happening here is Grievous is turning into a DPS machine. The chained jump attacks are coming out way faster than Grievous's regular standing attacks would, and when paired with star cards like Sith Trained or Lineup Weaklings, Grievous is just ridiculous with the amount of damage he can dish out. Again, this one is all in the timing, and it has everything to do with holding your block down while you do this move. If you're trying to do this and you're not holding down block, you'll notice that you won't be able to chain those jumps like you should be able to. This one will probably take some more practice than the other ones, but once you get it down, it's very satisfying. And finally, we're gonna move on to our last tip, which just has to do with a star card for Darth Maul. And the reason I want to talk about it is because it's omitting some information that you should probably know. The lightsaber defense star card on Darth Maul states that when Darth Maul does his spin attack, he gets a 16% damage reduction from blaster bolts specifically. But what the card will not tell you is that he also takes 60% damage reduction from lightsabers while doing the spin attack. And this is super crucial when he's getting parried, since Darth Maul is a very easy hero to parry. With lightsaber defense, you'll take way less damage when you do get hit. For me, this is a staple in duels. If I'm going into Hero Showdown with Darth Maul, I 100% have lightsaber defense equipped, and there's just no questions about it. Kind of an anticlimactic one for the final tip, but I thought it was a good one that I think a lot of people still do not know yet. But that is it for today's video. Those are 7 advanced lightsaber tips plus the 3 requisites. I think I can safely call this 10 tips in today's video. Thank you all so much for stopping by and checking it out. If you found any of these tips helpful, let me know in the comments below, and don't forget to give this video a thumbs up. Let me know what your favorite tip was and which one you're most eager to try. Make sure you're subscribed to the channel and you're getting notified so that you don't miss a single video. We've got plenty more Star Wars video game content on the way, so make sure you stick around for it. Thanks a lot, guys. I'll see you in the next one. Peace.